1,000 ringgit. With just that 1,000, if you do it right, you could turn that 1,000 into 2,000, 3,000, 5,000, maybe even 10,000. How? By investing. Investing means making your money work for you. Investing can also ensure you have a comfortable life even after you retire. Welcome back to Mr. Money TV, the channel that makes financial knowledge fun. How do you begin investing? With just 1,000 ringgit. Here are 5 ways. Number 1, Malaysian stocks. There is no place like home. Bursa Malaysia is our local stock exchange where you may invest in companies that are publicly listed. When you purchase a company's stock, you essentially own part of the company. When the company makes money, you make money. Simple. To begin investing in the stock market, you will need to have a CDS and trading account, which you can get by signing up with a local brokerage. From there, you will just need to deposit money and begin searching for companies to invest in. In Bursa Malaysia, the minimum amount of stocks you must purchase is 100 units. For example, if stock A is 1 ringgit, it'll be 1 ringgit multiplied by 100 units and there'll be 100 ringgit. That means in order to buy that stock, you will need a minimum of 100 ringgit. With 1,000 ringgit, you have many choices of stocks you can pick from. Ideally, you want to find a stock that is priced below 5 ringgit to ensure you are able to hold a significant amount. But don't just let the stock price be the deciding factor when it comes to picking stocks. Successful investing comes from researching the company you like to invest in. What does the company do? How are their financials? What is their business model like? How is their management? More importantly, don't just buy a stock because someone somewhere told you or you read it online. Number 2, US stocks. Looking beyond Malaysia, we have US stocks where there are companies such as Google, Apple, and Microsoft. Why not consider investing in them? Investing in US stocks has 3 big advantages. Firstly, a lot of exciting technological development and growth happens in the US. Think of Tesla, Apple, Google, with huge growth rates. Secondly, investing in the US means having a broader market exposure, meaning that you're able to jump into various opportunities beyond local ones. Thirdly, the exchange rate. We know that the US currency is stronger than ours, and because of that, your profit gains will be higher. And on top of that, if our local currency weakens, you have peace of mind that your US stock portfolio will most likely be largely unaffected. The biggest concern Malaysians have when investing in US stocks is the cost. The truth is, US stocks are expensive for us when you factor in the exchange rate. Look at Amazon's stock price at $3,200+. If we were required to purchase a minimum of 100 units, you'd need a minimum of basically a lot lah, right? Yeah, you need a lot of money. But don't worry, you don't need to buy the minimum 100 units like Malaysian stocks. Instead, with eToro, you are able to buy what is called fractional shares, meaning you can buy a stock based on the amount of money you have rather than the stock price. What a golden feature, right? Speaking of things related to gold, it would be really golden if you would help us press the like button to help us with the YouTube algorithm. Done? You're the best. Number 3, gold. Commonly known as the asset that protects investors against inflation and recession. Most investors have gold in their portfolios to diversify from just having currency-backed assets. In the old days, to invest in gold, people commonly resorted to buying gold jewelries and gold bars. The problem with gold jewelries is that you don't get much gold in it. And even if you do, there is workmanship costs involved. Someone needs to take that gold, someone needs to melt it, and someone needs to craft it. All of that incurs costs. Cost to you. What about gold bars? Investing in gold bars also has a few problems. First, gold bars were expensive. Secondly, they were heavy, which makes them very mafan to move around. Third, it was dangerous to move them around and keep them secure. What if your neighbors all knew you were keeping gold bars under your bed? Not anymore. Now you can invest in gold starting with just 10 ringgit. Simply head on over to Quantum Metal to begin investing in gold. Number 4, cryptocurrency, dubbed as the new gold. Cryptocurrency is a digital currency that is neither owned by a bank or person. The reason why it's dubbed as the new gold is because, like gold, it is limited. You cannot produce more, like how you can print more money. And that means, theoretically, it is more resistant to inflation. Is that good or bad? Oh, it depends on who you're asking. Some think that it's the next currency that we'll be using, whereas some think it's just a fad that will die off eventually. The good news is that today, we're seeing more and more financial institutions investing in it. So that could be a sign of something? Who knows? There are many cryptocurrencies in the market, but right now the most popular one is Bitcoin, which has grown over 350%. The great thing about Bitcoin is that you can also start investing in it with as little as just 10 ringgit on Luno. So why not consider being part of that growth too? If you'd like to know more about Bitcoin and how does it all work, check out this video here. Number 5, robo-advisors. Maybe you don't want to pick your own stock or actively monitor things like stock price, gold price, and Bitcoin price, but you just want to have it managed for you. Consider a robo-advisor. A robo-advisor is similar to unit trust, except with robo-advisors, there is no human fund manager, therefore reducing the potential errors of bias and human mistakes, as well as management fees. How does it work then? Robo-advisors use algorithms that automatically help you invest in different types of asset classes such as stocks, bonds, and index funds based on the risk appetite and investment goal you have. There are many robo-advisors in the Malaysian market such as Stashaway, Wahid Invest, and MyTheo. With robo-advisors, you can either invest your 1,000 ringgit in a lump sum or slowly deposit it on a monthly basis. This isn't an exhaustive list, and our suggestion is that you select no more than 2 from the list above to avoid over-diversification, also known as diversification. Spreading your 1,000 ringgit too thin may prevent you from getting significant profit. So what are you waiting for? Let's get investing.